गुड मॉर्निंग समर्थ, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन।
हाउ आर यू सर?
सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हियर अगेन खराडे सर एंड आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू टू अ ऑनलाइन लेक्चर। सो इन दिस लेक्चर टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द मॉरिशियस लेसन, विच दिस इज द सेकंड लेसन फ्रॉम योर टेक्स्ट बुक मॉरिशियस। I told you about the country, about the Mauritius and where its location also. Location of Mauritius also I explained, and it is a travelogue. It is a travelogue. So now, before going to continue the topic Mauritius, again the previous knowledge I want to discuss here. In the first paragraph, the writer R.K. Lakshman described about Atlas world map and also about the location of Mauritius. Then he described clouds from the sky. Yesterday I had given you the question that how did author describe clouds? How did author describe clouds? So he described clouds from aircraft, and the clouds I glimpsed the ocean spread like a bluish green steel sheet, and there are acres and acres of cloud below me having all sorts of funny shapes in an odd abstract way. Curiously they resemble figures in the ancient legends of China, Rome, Greece, India, and what have you. Then we learn that Mauritius is an odd mixture of race and language. It is a mixture of society and language, and different types of people they live in Mauritius are Chinese, Biharis, Dutch, Persians and Tamils, Arabs, French and English. They all live merrily with one another, and there is a oneness, sense of oneness. Then the writer described one incident with Radha Krishna Govindan, and he was from Tamil Nadu. He was a Tamil, but he forgot his mother tongue, and he had become totally Mauritius. So he forgot, he stopped pronouncing Tamil sounds centuries ago. It was the effect of Mauritius that we have learned, dear students. Now next fifth paragraph I am going to discuss. 5th, 6th, 7th and 8th I will discuss today in this lecture. This topic is hard to understand, and again it is lengthy, so paragraph wise we are going to learn. Just pay attention and listen carefully the Mauritius lesson. Mauritius. Mauritius is here, dear students, and now fifth paragraph. Like others of his fellow men, his ancestors were brought to the islands as slaves or later as indentured laborers to work in sugarcane fields and factories, or to cut timber in the jungle and haul it to the boats. Their roots in their original homelands weathered and disappeared with the passage of time. All of them together happily came to share in the triumphs and defeats of whoever happened to be their masters,
among the bickering trinity of those days, the Dutch, the French, the English, who constantly waged a battle for the position of the island, for its species and sugar, or just for the strategic position on the maritime route to the east. Then, conveniently placed as it was for political purposes. So, dear students, in the fifth paragraph, here, as I told you, in the Mauritius, different people are there, and they are from China, from India, from Dutch and Arab, French, Tamil. So from other society, many people are there, as I told you. But how they came to Mauritius? I told you that Mauritius is known as mini India. Why? Because in Mauritius, many Indians are there. We are Indians. So Indian people are there, they live. But then, not only for living, dear students, they accepted the citizenship of Mauritius. But first, in the fifth paragraph, here the writer described the history. History. Why history? Because how did they go there? What was the reason to go there? From India to Mauritius, what was the reason to go or shift from India to Mauritius? What was the reason to go or shift? I told you that in Mauritius, Indians are there, Indian people are there. And why? What was the reason to go there and to settle down? To shift there and to settle down? So there is one history. And what is the history? We are going to learn. So dear students, Now in Mauritius, Indian people are there, but they have become totally Mauritius. They accepted the citizenship of Mauritius, but first, reason to go or shift first. Here, insectors were brought to island as slaves. So it was a reason. Yeah. Reason to go or shift. What was the reason? Because ancestors were brought to island as slaves. So what is the meaning of ancestors? Ancestors means what? Our generations, like father's father, father's grandfather, grandfather's father, then that father's grandfather, that is called generation, that is called ancestors. So here, now those who are living in Mauritius, now whoever are living in Mauritius, their ancestors means what? Who? Wait. Voice is breaking. Okay. Now check. Okay, so now check. Shivani, now check about. Hello. Can you hear? Can you hear, dear students? Shivani, can you hear my voice? Okay, so now insects were brought to island as slaves. So there now those who are living in Mauritius, their insects were brought to island. To island is what? To Mauritius. They were brought to Mauritius for as slaves. So not only as a citizen, as a slaves, because in the history, British, Dutch, French battle was going on. Every time they used to fight, yes, no, every time they used to fight, and that's why here dear students, here what happened? Because of from India, the people were brought to island as a slave. Here I say people, then you will understand. People were brought to island as a slaves only. So they were slaves. So as a slaves only, the people were brought to island. And what was the reason why all they brought? I will write here. So, dear students, now here people were brought to island as slaves. Reasons. First reason, laborers to work in sugar cane fields. Next, then to cut timber in jungle and to howl it to the woods. So, dear students, now, yes, now is it okay, Shivani?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now, people were brought to island as slaves. So, in past, in history, From India, people were brought to that Mauritius. People from India to Mauritius, French or English, yes, no, British. They brought all the people from India to island as a slave. So, as a slave first they brought. from India to Mauritius. Why? What was the reason to bring people from India to Mauritius as slaves? Reasons are 1, 2, and 3. So the first reason, laborers to work in sugarcane fields, because in Mauritius sugarcane field is more. Sugarcane field is more. Because in Mauritius sugarcane field is more, so that's why laborers means workers. So workers to work in sugarcane fields. That was the first reason. From India to Mauritius, people were brought to Mauritius to work in sugarcane field only as a slaves, not as a owner, not as a worker, slaves. Because that time India also was under the British rule. Yes, no. India was under British rule. So Indian people were brought to island, to Mauritius, as slaves to work in sugarcane fields, to cut timber in the jungle. To cut timber in the jungle is what? To cut wood or trees. To cut wood or trees in the jungle, and that trees to haul it to the boats. Haul means to carry. To carry it to the boats. Because boats, why? Because Mauritius is in ocean, it is an island. So boats were used to carry the wood, the trees. And that's why these are the three reasons why people were brought to island from India. So who will give the answer? I just want to ask you, what are the reasons to bring people from India to Mauritius? Who will give answer? Tell me the reasons. Yes. Okay, very good. Now who will tell what are the reasons to bring people from India to Mauritius? Shivani. These are three reasons to bring people from India to Mauritius. People were brought to island as slaves. Why? Because to as laborers to work in sugarcane fields, because in Mauritius sugarcane field is more, and that's why workers to work in sugarcane fields, to cut timber in jungle, to haul it to the boats. These are three reasons. So for this work, Indian people were brought, shifted to Mauritius in history only. So now what happened? So some people as slaves, they were shifted to Mauritius, and then their original this appeared little time. Little time. So that's why, dear students, here very important part, that people were brought to Mauritius for this work, and the people, their original roots of homelands. Original roots of homelands means what? Original roots of homelands means homeland. India is homeland. China is homeland. Afghanistan is homeland. Sri Lanka, homeland. So their country, that is called homeland, but people from that countries were shifted to Mauritius as slaves. So their original roots of homeland disappeared with time. Disappeared means what? They were shifted to Mauritius as slaves, but by the time they forgot their country, they forgot everything, and their original roots of homelands disappeared permanently. Automatically, their original roots of homelands disappeared with time. So all these slaves, started living there only, because there was no chance to escape from English people. So they accepted that Mauritius is the only homeland. There was no escape, no way to escape. So they accepted Mauritius as homeland, and their original roots of homelands disappeared with time. Their original. There means what? Peoples. So this is important part of the Mauritius. So now their roots in their original homelands weathered and disappeared with the passage of time, and all of them together happily came to share in the triumphs and defeats of whoever happened to be their masters among the vicarying trinity of those days, the Dutch, the French, and the English. So now their original homelands disappeared, but one thing was there. The thing was, they happily came to share victory and defeat of Dutch, French, and English. This is important part again, dear students. What? They happily came to share victory and defeats of Dutch, French, and English. So people were brought to Mauritius as slaves to work in sugarcane field, to cut the trees and to carry the trees to the boats. So they forgot their homeland, and the homeland, everything totally disappeared automatically by the time. And now they happily came to share. Now all these people, whoever brought to Mauritius, they accepted their life and they happily started living there. But they shared the victory and defeats of their masters. Means in Mauritius also, three countries were there. Battle was there, the battle between Dutch, French, and English. Battle was there. Like in India also, there was a battle between Mughal, then battle between Maratha and Mughal, then battle between Dutch and Portuguese, the battle between English and Portuguese, Dutch, Portuguese, English, Dutch, Portuguese, English. The battle was there. Same in Mauritius also, there was battle between Dutch, French and English. So sometimes Dutch, yes no, sometimes the victory, Dutch got the victory, sometimes French got the victory, sometimes English used to get the victory. So their masters, the people's masters, sometimes Dutch, sometimes French, sometimes English. So there was a battle, always battle. So sometimes English, they got the victory and they became master of the slaves. Again Dutch and English fighting, Dutch became master, Dutch got victory. They became the master of the Mauritius and then French also. So there was a battle between Dutch, French and English. And other people, they started living happily here in Mauritius. So now, what was the reason of battle? I'm just going to write. Here, Dutch, French and English. There was battle between Dutch and English and French and all. So the reason was, reasons. First one, for a possession of the island, for its species,
yes, sir,
and sugar. And another reason is also here, for the position. So these two reasons are there for the battle, the reasons for the battle, Dutch, French and English. First reason was a possession of the island for its species and sugar. So in island sugar was there, sugar cane field was more, and because of sugar cane field sugar was more, and species means ocean, seas, species. So everything, and possession means what? Ownership. This is my island. Mauritius is my only. I am the owner of Mauritius. Possession, ownership. So the ownership of the island for its species and sugar, and for the position also. Second reason is important. For the position also. Because the British came in India also for the position, and then they started their rule, and that's why here also English people were there for the position, battle was there, for the ownership of the island, battle was there. And sometimes Dutch, sometimes French, sometimes English, they used to win the battle and they became the master of the slaves of the Mauritius. But actually the people from India, they happily lived there because they forgot their original roots of homelands, automatically disappeared. Because they were brought as slaves by English, by Dutch, by French to work in sugarcane field and to cut the trees and to haul it, to carry it to the boat. Dear students, understood paragraph? Yes. Veena is not there. Kirtana, understood the paragraph?
Yes, sir.
Kirtana, tell me two reasons of battles. Why the battle was there, Dutch, French and English. Two reasons for battle. Okay.
Sir, I don't have textbook, sir.
Hey, here I have written two reasons. Two reasons of for yes, battle.
First reason is the possession of the island for its spices and sugar, sir. Second reason is for the position, sir.
For the position. So that's why they used to fight. And the battle between who? Battle between who? Very good, very good. So, dear students, there was battle between French and Dutch also, and among these three, means English, Dutch, French, English, Dutch, French, always they used to fight. So, this paragraph I have completed here. Now, next paragraph, sixth paragraph. However, the battle of 1810 ended all that in favor of the English. The French surrendered and handed over the island after extracting a favor from the conquerors that the French influence on the island be left intact. The English kept their word to the last day of their rule, which ended in 1968. And so, we will have very musical but unpronounceable names like Truxtun Beaches, View Basin, Quarter Bonds, Curiepipe, Rose Belly, and so on. So now, dear students, the battle between Dutch, French and English, the battle amongst English, French and Dutch, but last, the battle of 1810 ended. Finally, the battle ended, dear students, in 1810. In 1810, battle ended finally, and who won the battle? English got victory at last. Finally, English got victory at last, because you know in India also English got victory, and English, the British people, they became the masters of the country. So the battle of 1810 ended. Finally, battle ended between French and English. That was the battle. So English got a victory at last, and then the French surrendered and handed over. French surrendered and handed over the island. So English got a victory at last, and French surrendered themselves, and they finally handed over the island to the British people, to the English people. But they requested that there should be French influence on the island. So they requested for the French influence, and then at last, dear students, English also in 1968, last day of English rule. So from 1810 to 1968, there was rule of English. And in 1968, English rule ended. English rules ended. So finally, English also ended. 1968, why? Because 1947 also, we also got freedom. We also got freedom in 1947, and Mauritius people, they got freedom in 1968. So that time Mauritius people, they used to live there. From India also they visited, they shifted from India, shifted from Bangladesh, Pakistan, Afghanistan, Sri Lanka. So all people were there in the island, but the battle of 1810 ended there. English got victory at last. French surrendered and handed over the island finally. But from 1810 to 1968, there was rule of English people. But in 1968, English rules ended. And then Mauritius became independent country, like we got freedom. So that time only Mauritius got the freedom. So dear students, here we are going to stop. Did you understand whatever I taught in this lecture?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Wait.
Yes sir.